the official. Referee is Mr. Takeoff. Judges is Mr. House, Beanie and Bandesi. Timekeeper is Mr. Chetani. Dr. Pungan is at the ringside. And Mr. Mahavamala is the principal officer. Now the contestants. On my left, in white and red trunks, weighing 50.46 kgs. This is his nice piece of record, ladies and gentlemen. He has 14 fights, 13 wins, no loss, one draw, and seven of them couldn't go the distance. Ladies and gentlemen, from Tangan Village, I introduce to you Toto, the silent killer, Mokoroto. And on the opposite corner, in red, white, and blue trunks, weighing 50.50 kg. This is his nice piece of record, ladies and gentlemen. He has 15 fights, 13 wins, one loss, one draw, and eight of his contestants couldn't go the distance. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you the defending champion from Tanzania, Zolile, the Bone Crusher, Mbiki. And hopefully you'll enjoy the best of it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Well, there you have it.
What's up? What's up?
The table has been laid. And the two boxers are coming close to each other. And
I'm expecting
your referee,
a very
Mr.
good
Pakabine,
fight.
Jacob.
Stick to the boxing rules. Obey my instructions at all times. Wish you good luck. Shake hands.
There you have it, and the referee has said it. This is, and welcome back to the tennis stadium here in Selborne Park in East London, the mecca of boxing in the Eastern Cape or in South Africa. The fight is held here at Selborne Park Stadium because the organizers thought the audience theater would be very small. Loisa.
Yes, Jumile, welcome to East London. This one is the big one, the one everybody's been waiting for. Two boys, two hot prospects from our area fighting it out. Wherever you're born, in classrooms, in toilets, in taxis, in trains, in everything, people have been talking about this one. And now, this is the moment for everybody to walk the talk. He really came of age as a professional when he beat Daniel Ward. But today, this is for him to prove whether beating Daniel Ward was just a slash in the pan or a safe of things to come. But it looks like at this moment of the fight is starting, he is in some trouble as Toto Mokoroto is changing angles on him, beating him to the punch, changing the punches from head to body, and it looks like Zolile Mbiki will have to work out something to get himself back into the fight.
This is first round, scheduled for 12. The South African flyweight title between these two young men, Zolile Mbiki, the champion, and Toto Mokoroto, the challenger.
Toto Mokoroto is fighting on the back foot. He's tackling this man. Mbiki has started to get into him with his punching now. His punching, and Mbiki is walking forward, trying to hit the body and the head. But Toto Mokoroto is tackling him. He's the first out of the two. But Whether he will be able to sustain that condition, be able to sustain those punches, it will be for everybody to see as the fight goes on.
Well, it's toe-to-toe and punch-for-punch in this fight at this, the first round.
It's toe-to-toe. The pace of this fight is very high. And whether these boys will be able to take and carry on this pace for as long as it takes is for us very, very interesting to see.
And the first round, and let's hear what the corners have to say. Well, there you have it. That looked like a push from Zoyl Mbiji, and the referee did not count. Looks like, doesn't look like a push to me, looks like a punch.
Here we go, Jumile, for the second round of the fight between the champion Zoyl Mbiji and challenger Toto Mokoroto. It has been a very, very hard day. Akale phezulu ngamandla kangangoba olu hlobo acale ngalo ukuba kunokuqhubekeka ama ngolu hlobo enye yawo ukuba ikhe yadinwa iyaba senkathazweni.
Well, looking at the slow-mo of that knockdown in the first round, it does not look like a push to me. It looked more like a punch on Toto Mokoroto when he went down on his back, but the referee said it's no knockdown, and the men are back to their feet in the second round.
I didn't notice that one, Jumile. I don't know what really happened. But all I can tell you is that these guys are really hitting each other now. Really going hammer and tongs. No quarter up and none given.
Stop, stop! Don't use the shoulder! Back.
Well, you can hear the referee clear there. Don't use the shoulder. But for Toto Mokoroto.
Do you think these guys are going to hold on to this kind of pace for some time?
Well, it will depend as to whether one of them can pace himself. And if we look at Zoyl Mbiji, he's able to pace himself. He paced himself very well in the first round, and he was never overawed by the fourth pace started by Toto Mokoroto.
That's very true.
He's been doing very, very well so far. And looking at Toto Mokoroto, he's been a little bit careless at times. He moved very well in the first round. Now he's been a little bit careless. He's been caught by a few punches from Zoyl Mbiji.
In fact, what I'm looking at, I don't really like the way he is moving and the way he keeps his mouth open as he throws punches. With this kind of pace, Toto Mokoroto might not see the distance as strong as he is. He might tire down in the process. He's having his mouth wide open. He's fighting all the time. He's jumping around, and Zoyl Mbiji is really walking towards him. And with that kind of pace, we may see a tired Toto Mokoroto as the fight goes on down.
Well, Vila Uloise and Sijikuwe, no quarter off and no quarter given.
And they are really giving it to each other now, both to the body and the head. And Toto Mokoroto is again starting to breathe. And Zoyl Mbiji is taking the fight to him, putting on the pressure, throwing punches from both hands.
And
Toto Mokoroto was nearly flawed by that one. That was it. Very big left from Toto Mokoroto. It really shook Zoyl Mbiji. Hats off for Zoyl Mbiji for being able to take that one big left hand. That has always dropped a lot of people.
Stop.
Both boxers throwing punches, and then Zoyl Mbiji caught him with a very deep right hand, and Toto Mokoroto wobbles. And then this time, is Ndichi again going for Dr. Mokoroto.
Right. Now, I want you to see more body punches now. I want to see, more body punches.
So,
okay?
Who pack a missing
dog? No, I promise you.
Huh?
The
thing.
Okay. 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 Keep on walking.
And here we go for round number three. Selvan Pakistan and champion Zolambiki and Toto Mokoroto. The two boys have really gone for each other, but the way this fight is going and the way these guys are punching, it will certainly not go to the end of the fight, as I can see. But at this point in time, I can see Toto Mokoroto throwing punches, very fast punches, but he's rather careless at times, and Zolambiki is able to throw his punches where he likes, which means now, if Toto Mokoroto cannot drop Zolambiki now, you might see a tired Toto Mokoroto along the way. But the way he is throwing his punches and catching this is, he might drop him. Toto Mokoroto is the kind of southpaw everybody dreams about. A southpaw can throw a jab, a southpaw can move sideways, a southpaw can throw every punch in the book. But today, you can be sure that Ndichi, very, very awkward, is going to stay on top of him and pressurize him right through. And Zolambiki Ndichi is doing right now.
Well, he's been doing that, especially at the beginning of the second round. And he tried to, he was not overawed by the pace Toto Mokoroto started this fight with.
He's very confident to be the lighter champion. He's really taking the fight his man, though he is receiving punishment. But what I've been looking at now is that he is also able to put his punches where he wants them.
He has been able to break Mokoroto's rhythm, and Mokoroto is not fighting with the same pace he was fighting at the beginning. And I can look like Biki also has a cup below his eyes.
He also has got a cup. And like I say, Jimile, I'm afraid about the kick of the fight. It is so deep, and any guy who is unable to pace himself here is going to find himself very, very, very tired indeed.
Well, a barrage of punches coming from both boxers.
Umbiki uthi makhalanga ndideni bandibethe ndibulawa bandiyabulawa le title yam ndifuna ukodla nayo. Toto Mokoroto uze ngamandla uthi le title ayifanelanga uba yakho, le title yam. And at this point Toto is boxing beautifully, but it looks like Zolambiki is putting on the pressure, and it's not as easy as it started on Toto Mokoroto. Toto Mokoroto, uchongezimbi ezitoko Zolambiki, but wathakutsho wangathi utheka Ndichi, Ndichi yiza uzokulwa because Ndichi ubethile. Toto Mokoroto uphose apho nge-right hand, waphosa wokuwa uluse ibalance. I don't know whether ikwenzalo is something abonisa ukuba ebefuna ukubulalana ngalaphakathi ayikhali. Iminenzi yakhe soyifakala na? Ngathi iminenzi yakhe iyoyifakala uba ankoni.
And that's a clear sign of that his rhythm is gone, he's lost his rhythm, and that will make him more tired.
And we are only going now for the fourth round, and I don't like the look of his legs, really. And if you can do that and you are throwing punches, what will happen now is that you can get better than that.
Well, we're in round number four, scheduled for sale. The South African junior flyweight title between these two young pugilists. Referee, Mr. Pagamile Jacob. lo hizo Econa acá, Joel Embiid, que Bacal Flat en el lado, y de San Batua.
That is very clever because he will be able to see all the punish coming because once Ilanga Ali Flatele Alizo Umpanda Lipan the opponent yakhe. Ikona Toto Mokoroto and DJ if it is new, if it is short of put on the pressure. But whether it is that is true, it needs to be seen.
Cross boxes in the center of the ring.
It's broken because the pace has been so hard.
Well, that's a wonderful rise for Toto Mokoroto. Only started professional boxing in 1990. And only 3 years since he started professional boxing, he's already challenging for the South African title, and he's already had an international fight against Saldana.
He has had three international fights, one against a Mexican, one against a Kenyan in Johannesburg, and then one against Saldana here, yes, and he stopped all those guys.
Well, there's been talk of the Saldana fight between Toto Mokoroto and Saldana being a walkover for Toto Mokoroto, Saldana not being a worthy opponent.
It was a real walkover, and he's in a fight today. But at this point, he's boxing very beautifully. He's circling, moving around Golden Biggie, throwing punches to the body and head. And Golden Biggie at this point is just walking towards Mokoroto. Mokoroto is doing the scoring. Mokoroto is doing the punching, doing the scoring. Vici is walking, just putting on the pressure, walking forward.
Just almost 60, the global club up there, going to be the same. Chiquelo is spinning. Chiquelo up on Fondini, down strong, in that key, Okabe. A poi full out, Nick Ezeela. Jama, Israeli Vici, a posta is strong, and Langella.
And Golden Biggie logo, Okali Lukusela, Naye Elzatongo, Ukutekuspa, Toto Mokoroto, Utinagan Tibisela, Kotwa, Jemak Tumin, Jemati, Kosenzima, Yaye Kunzimanje, Kosoka, Botwa.
I must commend the two corners, they did very well to stop the flow of blood from the car. Round number 5, scheduled for 12. You heard in Golden Beach's corner, Zimartin Goni was helping and assisting there. Said, use the body, hit the body because he's moving around all over. A good shot from Toto Mokoroto. Good travel up that combination there. Mokoroto throwing the passes.
What I'm noticing here to me is that when Toto Mokoroto throws his punches, he really goes by his punches, and even when Golden Biggie scores, Toto Mokoroto is still there throwing, and that's very, very dangerous for Golden Biggie. Toto Mokoroto is looking very, very positive.
A deceiving look about his fight, and yet he's lost, and come back and throw a barrage of punches, a 1-2, but really it hurt the champion here this afternoon.
In fact, he may have been tired, or felt tired, but it looks like he has got his second win now, and that is a sign of fitness, that the guy is fully prepared for this kind of brawl.
Well, he's got another cut above his eye. That could be a problem, and he just sees that he throws his punches on that cut.
Vici is looking at making that catch very bad indeed for that the referee either stop it or the doctor.
Well, a very worried Mokoroto's corner and supporters when the referee had a look at that card. Could mean anything, the end of the fight, or he can carry on. It depends on the referee, as BG once again.
A very good try turn from BG there.
When Nils Gamsjes went, it looked like he's being asked to get on with the fight.
I like the way Dr. Mokoroto is giving BC angles there. He's very nimble to take, and BC thinks he's here. The next thing, Dr. Mokoroto is this side, and he's throwing very big and many, many punches there. And Tony Lombic goes for it now. He got it with a good right hand, he really got it. But Mokoroto is so bad, but BC is really catching him now. Very big punches from Tony Lombic. That was a very good finish from Tony Lombic. He really caught him there.
Well, one thing BC knew was that his gum shield is not in his mouth, and he had to throw those punches to stop him from coming at him. And he threw very, very strong punches.
Sort of touch is bad, very bad, and you need a superhuman effort and expertise to stop it.
Let's have a look at that. That is a barrage of punches thrown by Zoyan Biki, the champion. And Toto Mokoroto has no answer for those punches. And it has actually made Toto Mokoroto's cut look very, very bad, and that could mean the end of the fight very soon.
Here we go, Zoyan Biki is the champion. He really put on the pressure in the nine is the previous round. Now we're going to see whether he's going to take from where he left off. And already Toto Mokoroto is giving him the angle. Moving to the wrong side of Zoyan Biki. And so Zoyan Biki catch him again. Zoyan Biki catch him again. And Mokoroto is in trouble. And Mokoroto is very wobbly now. And Zoyan Biki goes. Knockout. He scored with a very beautiful right hand. Toto Mokoroto went flat his head, hit the canvas. He's not going to beat the count. It's a knockout, and it's the end of Toto Mokoroto. And Zoyan Biki is winner and still champion.
Well, it's jubilation in the corner of Toto Mokoroto. Very good fight. He sized him up. He took his time. Was never overawed by the pace of the fight. In fact, the pace started changing from time to time. But this young man, Zoyan Biki, proved he is a worthy champion. Let's have a look at this. Look at that, very close. Total punches in the jaw, and he goes. And that was the end of a very, very good fight here this afternoon.
That was a beautiful, well-timed right hand. And it proved Zoyan Biki to be a very worthy champion. Toto Mokoroto, a very worthy challenger. But today, he was out of depth. Zoyan Biki wanted to defend his title and he really went in there. And here again, we show the slow motion. And there goes Zoyan Biki's right hand, the one that really did the damage. And it made Toto Mokoroto very wobbly before he threw the Kuji Grace, the big right hand that knocked him out. And then this fight now shows today that Zoyan Biki is the best flyweight in South Africa. Unlike has always been said that Toto Mokoroto is the man. Zoyan Biki put him in his place today, and there are bigger things maybe for him. A well rating and a well title fight. Now let's give over to Zoyan Biki. Let's go again to Jumila Mateta to interview Zonile.
Spumpool, Sydney Studio, a little slow to come to the centre of the ring.
Come. Boxer, keep boxing rules. Obey my commands. Boxer, wish you good luck. Second.
This could be a very interesting contest. The junior middleweight division in South Africa is a rich division in talent. There are lots of talented fighters. The likes of Joe Devani, Pretorius, Eric Spalding, of course, waiting in the wings. Mpush Makambi, the making his second defense after looking very impressive against Enwil Nashile in the same ring a couple of months back. Sydney Msudu though, Bert, interesting move for him. His last fight was as a welterweight a year ago. He lost that contest. It was an international bout, rather disappointingly. And now he's up in weight. He's got his hands full against Makambi, surely this afternoon.
Well, unquestionably, Nick. And Lucas Kampanis, the trainer of Msudu, said that he had unbelievable problems making welterweight. And in fact, he blames this for the poor performance that Msudu put up against Delroy Bryan. It was more than a year ago. So he's had no alternative except to move up. But the big question, I think, is going to be how he's going to handle someone like Makambi in the heavier division. One other thing, both men are essentially counter-punchers. And this should make for an interesting fight because somebody has got to lead. And from what we've seen so far, it looks like Makambi is prepared to do that.
I think Nubeck Makambi has the...